Carvedilol is a non-selective beta-adrenergic antagonist used to treat mild to severe chronic heart failure, hypertension, and left ventricular dysfunction following myocardial infarction in clinically stable patients. In this video, let's find found. What is carvedilol? What is carvedilol used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking carvedilol? How does carvedilol work? How to use carvedilol? What is carvedilol? Carvedilol, sold under the brand name Coreg among others, is a medication used to treat high blood pressure, congestive heart failure, and left ventricular dysfunction in people who are otherwise stable. For high blood pressure, it is generally a second-line treatment. It is taken by mouth. Carvedilol was patented in 1978 and approved for medical use in the United States in 1995. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 26th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 23 million prescriptions. What is carvedilol used for? Carvedilol is indicated to treat mild to severe heart failure, left ventricular dysfunction after myocardial infarction with ventricular ejection fraction less than or equal to 40%, or hypertension. Contraindication. Carvedilol should not be used in patients with bronchial asthma or bronchospastic conditions due to increased risk of bronchoconstriction. It should not be used in people with second or third degree atrioventricular block, sick sinus syndrome, severe bradycardia, unless a permanent pacemaker is in place, or a decompensated heart condition. People with severe hepatic impairment should use carvedilol with caution. Side effects. The most common side effects, greater than 10% incidence, of carvedilol include dizziness, fatigue, low blood pressure, diarrhea, weakness, slow heart rate, weight gain, erectile dysfunction. Carvedilol is not recommended for people with uncontrolled bronchospastic disease, e.g. current asthma symptoms, as it can block receptors that assist in opening the airways. Pharmacodynamic. Carvedilol reduces tachycardia through beta-adrenergic antagonism and lowers blood pressure through alpha-1 adrenergic antagonism. It has a long duration of action as it is generally taken once daily and has a broad therapeutic index as patients generally take 10 to 80 mg daily. Patients taking carvedilol should not abruptly stop taking this medication as this may exacerbate coronary artery disease. Mechanism of action. Carvedilol inhibits exercise-induced tachycardia through its inhibition of beta-adrenoceptors. Carvedilol's action on alpha-1 adrenergic receptors relaxes smooth muscle and vasculature, leading to reduced peripheral vascular resistance and an overall reduction in blood pressure. At higher doses, calcium channel blocking and antioxidant activity can also be seen. The antioxidant activity of carvedilol prevents oxidation of low-density lipoprotein and its uptake into coronary circulation. Half-life. The half-life of carvedilol is between 7 to 10 hours, though significantly shorter half-lives have also been reported. Dose. The dose of this medicine will be different for different patients. For oral dosage form, extended-release capsules. For heart failure. Adults, at first, 10 mg, mg, once a day for at least 2 weeks. Your doctor may adjust your dose as needed. However, the dose is usually not more than 80 mg once a day. Children, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. For hypertension. Adults, at first, 20 mg, mg, once a day for 7 to 14 days. Your doctor may adjust your dose as needed. However, the dose is usually not more than 80 mg once a day. Children, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. For left ventricular dysfunction after a heart attack. Adults, at first, 20 mg, mg, once a day for 3 to 10 days. Your doctor may adjust your dose as needed. However, the dose is usually not more than 80 mg once a day. Children, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. For oral dosage form, tablets. For congestive heart failure. Adults, at first, 3.125 mg, mg, 2 times a day. Your doctor may adjust your dose as needed. However, the dose is usually not more than 25 or 50 mg, 2 times a day. Children, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. For high blood pressure, hypertension. Adults, at first, 6.25 mg, mg, 2 times a day. Your doctor may adjust your dose as needed. However, the dose is usually not more than 25 mg, 2 times a day. Children, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. For left ventricular dysfunction after a heart attack. Adults, at first, 6.25 mg, mg, 2 times a day. Some patients may start at 3.125 mg, 2 times a day. Your doctor may adjust your dose as needed. However, the dose is usually not more than 25 mg, 2 times a day. Children, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. Safety advice. Carvedilol falls into category C. In animal studies, pregnant animals were given this medication and had some babies born with problems. No well-controlled studies have been done in humans. Therefore, this medication may be used if the potential benefits to the mother outweigh the potential risks to the unborn child. That's all the information about carvedilol we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.